Good morning, Mohawks! I'm Rajania.
And I'm Chloe. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Face the flag, put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated.
Good morning, River Hawks. I hope you all have had a great first week back. And if I haven't had a chance to talk with you, I hope everyone had a wonderful spring break, even if it just meant they had downtime to relax and take some me time. This next week, we're going to be gearing up for CASP testing. We'll have minimum days on Thursday and Friday, and then the following Monday, the 22nd. Those days will be dedicated solely to CASP testing. No regular classes, just your CASP testing homerooms, which your team teachers will talk with you about next week if they haven't already. In the testing, a couple of things to remember. Most of what you'll be drawing on is knowledge from both your sixth and seventh grade years as seventh graders, and even some possible fifth grade knowledge. And then if you're eighth graders, seventh and eighth grade knowledge, possibly dipping into some of your sixth grade information. Most of it's recall. It's not really stuff you can study for, but what you can do is practice some good habits to prepare for the testing. So, for example, even if you don't usually eat breakfast in the mornings, one of the important things studies have shown helps students with their memory recall is eating a good, nutritious meal before they take tests. So please be sure on those mornings that you're taking time to get up early and eat a healthy breakfast. Also, getting good sleep the night before. So whatever your routine normally is, try to go to bed a little earlier and do a relaxing activity or calming activity 30 minutes prior to bedtime that does not involve screens. Why? As much as we all love our screens, myself included, they've shown in multiple studies that 30 minutes before bedtime, we really shouldn't be looking at our screens to help our brains be at their best. So make sure you get good rest, make sure you eat a good breakfast, and then be sure to have a snack at brunch time, whether it's something you bring from home or get from the cafeteria. That will help to fuel you for the second portion of the testing. Our school became a California Distinguished School this year because of the great work our students did last year. And I am confident that our students this year will carry on with our wonderful tradition of having high test scores because our families care about you being in a good school, and testing scores have a lot to do with how schools are ranked. And additionally, your teachers, the reason they put so much into your work and what they want you to do and how they want you to perform each day is because they care about your success and your future, which correlates with the state testing scores. The state testing scores aren't everything, but they are important to our future as a school and your future as a student. So River Hawks, work hard and do your best. Take a deep breath day of, and do the best that you can. If you're doing your best, that's all anyone can ask for. Thanks, Riverhawks. Happy Friday and have a great weekend.
Let's hear from Ace B to learn more about our upcoming LTA.
Hey, Riverhawks. On April 12th, we're hosting a lunchtime activity.
This LTA is going to be musical chairs, and it will be hosted on the quad.
We will do two rounds of eight people, and during the time of the round, you will not be able to touch or move any of the chairs.
See you there, Riverhawks!
Attention all NJHS members. Your 10 hours of community service and $10 donation are due today. Make sure to turn in both of these to the ASB window. Just as a reminder to 7th graders currently in NJHS, this must be completed in order for you to stay in NJHS next year. Thanks, Rio!
Hey, Riverhawks! RioTV needs your help. We need your pictures from school events this year, like dances. Go to pics.riotv.org and fill out the form with your best memories. Thanks, and make sure you only share pictures you're comfortable with showing on RioTV.
Hey, space fans, our next College of the Canyon Star Party is scheduled today and is free and open to all students and their families. Watch this to learn more.
Have you ever heard of esports? Do you have a Nintendo Switch? Do you think you're good at playing Mario Kart? Well, this is the perfect opportunity to display your skills and talents.
We would like to start our own mini esports league that will run until the end of the year. Today during lunch in the NPR, we will be holding a meeting for those that want to join.
The format of the competition will be 2 versus 2, so come to the event with your teammate. All of your questions will be answered during this meeting. See you soon, Riverhawks!
Woohoo! Now, here's more about a student at Rio.
Actually, I have a lot of stuffed animals, but I mean, like, the one that I've been spending the most time with is Bert. He's an axolotl. Probably Minecraft, just because you can do, like, whatever you want, really. Maybe spring rolls, also Bang Hoi. Search it up. Sodas, I guess. Like Dr. Pepper. Well, currently I'm reading the Harry Potter series, so I'm on the Order of the Phoenix. Red? I was gonna say black. I play the flute and the piano. I used to play soccer, and I don't play any sports right now. I think Christmas or Valentine's Day. It's just Valentine's Day is close to my birthday, and Christmas is Christmas.
Let's learn more about drama production auditions.
Hey, Riverhawks!
Do you want to be a part of a one-of-a-kind drama class? Do you want to be part of the fall and spring drama productions?
Do you want to work on stage and backstage?
Then consider joining the drama production class for the 2024 to 2025 school year.
One.
We'll be holding auditions for production drama class on April 23rd in the NPR at 3 to 6 p.m.
Please prepare a 1 to 2 minute monologue from a play.
No movie monologues.
No songs.
For any questions, please see Mr. O in room C1.
See you in the spotlight!
Our SCV Public Library returns with friendship bracelet making on Tuesday, April 16th at lunch in the library.
Space is limited, so sign up now. Visit the library for more details.
The library will be closed after school on Tuesday, April 16th. Please plan your rides accordingly.
Can you put the clues together and find out who this staff member is?
Hey, Riverhawks. Welcome back to Guess That Staff Member. Ready? Here are the clues. They grew up in Seattle, Washington, and later went to Seattle University. They played high school basketball and recently competed in a Spartan obstacle course. They enjoy to sing and write music. In their free time, they lift weights, hike, and watch their kids do sports. They have 2 sons, both in high school. Their favorite food is coffee. They have a pet cat named Luca. They teach 7th grade history in Team Tiger, and their room is D6. It is Miss Pulaski.
You are the sunlight in my growing.
Congratulations to the students enrolled in MSA Jump who participated in HOSA in Anaheim and placed top 5 in their events.
We couldn't be more proud. Keep up the good work.
Here's your daily dose of positivity. Success is getting what you want. Happiness is wanting what you get. W.P. Kinsella.
That's it for today. I'm Janya.
And I'm Chloe.
And we'll see you next time on RioTV.